First thing I'm going to do is disconnect the battery.
Yep, two Phillips head screws back here we're going to take out behind the steering wheel.
We got to unhook our wires down here. And I want to get a magic marker and mark exactly where these go.
Just finishing marking them all.
See this right here? This is a lineup mark where that steering wheel goes back on. Now you can take this off with a ratchet, but I'm going to ease all that pain. I'm going to use an impact wrench. Now let's go get an impact wrench.
All right, we went and got the steering wheel puller.
Let's see if this even resembles the part that we got.
There's the new one in comparison.
Yeah, it looks like it.
The new one did not come with a little retaining ring here.
Yeah, this push-on ring, that's going to be a big problem. We'll see what we can do. Get that loose enough, it'll come right on off. And then you can mash them tabs down and use it again. They got it getting loose. See, you mash them down, even though one broke, you can mash these back down and push it on there. It'll work again. And now, let's see what kind of problems we got. This thing here, the hazard switch, is right in the way of pulling that out. Where'd that thing go? Does this have a little lip on it? Let me look. Can you see?
Yeah, there's a little lip on that.
Oh yeah, I don't feel one.
Looks like I can see one.
Can't get to it. We're going to pull it out. Needle nose. Somebody coming up here?
No.
Keep on, I'm gonna get the magnet up here. Now we gotta unplug the harness down at the bottom of the steering wheel. And then again, maybe not, let's see. Yeah, we're gonna have to unplug it. These long harness right here. It goes all the way down here and plugs up in a slot. And you gotta get that off. We gotta pull this sleeve off. It has one screw up under there. And you gotta bring this all the way down. You gotta open this up. It's got a slot right up under here. Open it up. And you gotta very carefully pull this off without messing up that little wire that goes down through here. And it goes up here and works the selector. And they're very fragile. They'll break. Oh man, they'll break. This is the thing right here. It's encased in a little bitty thin piece of plastic that'll break off there. And them can be repaired. They're very, very tedious. Okay, now we can go down here. No, what we need to do now is to get this off. Let's see, we might not even have to fool with that. Let me get up in there and look. This is what we got unplugged. First, we gotta get some light in here, see what we're doing.
This is the one right here. And it was hooked in to this here. It just come undone. I didn't see any tabs on it.
I'm gonna undo this right here, pull this little string off right here. This is where it breaks, right there. And boy, that's a pain to try to fix. So I'm gonna take it off before we break it. Or I'm gonna try to. It's liable to break as you're pulling it off. I kid you not. All you gotta do is come out of there. Like that. This little thing off right here, if I could just see it. Now what? Like that right there. Oh, buddy. I repaired them before, and you know, it ain't nothing funny about that. I can just slip this up or take it completely out, maybe, and see what's going on with it. What? Damn, Jim, you ain't looking. Now, let's see what's going on with that thing. The spring part is our problem. And the spring is hooked in right there on both sides. It's not returning. It's sticking. So replacing this is probably not going to do us no good. Which side was it that wouldn't pull back up, you remember?
When you press down, put the blinker, the left blinker.
Yeah, when you pull down like that, it won't come back up. And you can see right there how much the spring is off of it. See it right there?
Yep.
This is the part broken in there. It has something to do with that spring. So what I'm going to do is go around here with a little file. This does have a little lip on it. And I get it smooth where this piece here will slide off. If I can find the file that you just brought. Once I get this back up there like that. No, I don't need that clearance like I thought. Got something there. Alrighty.
Come right off when we got the lip off of it.
That goes in there somehow or another. Now let's get that filings off of there. That may be a big choke.
You can see what's broke right here.
That there.
To there.
And I got to put all these in here without losing these springs. And that other piece went up in there. That's all I got to do. Let's see if I can do that. That goes in there. I'll have to see which way it's turned when I get in there. And these this is gonna have to be pushed out. Look at there. I got a little lip in there. Get a screwdriver. I'm gonna job my finger, that's what I'm gonna do.
One.
We got that baby out of there. And they, who said I was gonna be operating on ticks today?
More like fleas.
Yeah.
Don't sneeze.
Thought I had you out. You ever seen things are crazy?
You'd think that little old switch would have come with new ones.
No, it should have got the whole switch, you see. They just sent me part of the dang switch. Alrighty. Now to find out which way this thing turns. Probably turns like that since it's going up and down this way, let's see.
Goes right up in there and turns up and down in them things.
So that is how it went.
No, I see it's got a little lip where it won't come all the way out. Or it used to. Alright. I see. Where's the one we pulled off? Go get it. I'll hold that little monster in. Alright, let me see that other piece before I even start putting the first pin thing back on. What's the deal with that? What's the deal with that crap?
What is it?
What is it? It don't have the metal all the way around.
Oh. Looking through camera vision, I didn't see. Mashing them back down.
We'll mash these back down a little bit, maybe. Now, since this ain't metal all the way around here like the other one.
Very thin flat washer, perhaps.
Where'd it go?
Now, you laid it that away somewhere. There it is, hiding.
I don't understand that at all. I would say this needs a flat washer. Let's see if we can find
one. Gotta get one now. Had a little arm broke off. Yeah, buddy.
We had to find this up at the hardware store. To go back on here.
Now, is it advanced?
Oh, that's right. Auto parts store, excuse me.
Last night. And that was a big hold up, but we have it now.
There she be.
Cooking now.
Plugging the switch back up under here now. Putting this little tedious rascal back on. Tighten that up now.
Try to get it back just where it come off, because that is adjustable.
You can maybe can see the line still. I can.
The right lubricant I'll have to get later. We don't have none.
All right, we're fixing to go ahead and grease right in here. Right now, we're going to be just using white lithium grease, but you're supposed to use Lubriplate DS-ES, and we're gonna have to come back later and put that in. Right now, this is all we got. All right, he's fixing to put on the collar, and to do so you're going to have to put the key back in it and turn
and
the
bring
shifter
this down
all the way down
again.
Yeah.
If you break this, you've had a very bad day. This collar will hit that as you're putting it back on. Now we got to line this up on the very bottom and put that screw back in there, which is also very fun. That's the next. Taking our steering wheel puller back off.
All right, time to put back on the wheel. Make sure you line it up. There's lines here and here. Once again, you can do this without this, but this is easier. All right. Your next step, this one here just pushes in this hole. This is why you want to mark them in case you have to spend a whole day hunting down a particular push nut. Time to fight this back on over this. All right. Get this side, make sure it's going to line up, then we'll go back and retighten it right quick. Okay. Time to hook the battery back up, but it's always best to go ahead and clean these terminals. Save you some problems down the road.
Okay, it was this arm here on the inside. I done got it pinned down, can't show you. But it was hanging up in the plastic just a little bit. And we wouldn't get no blinker servers. So I took it out and bent it just a little bit where them little springs make it go back and forth very easily like the other side was doing.
Yeah.
Now we have blinkers.
It was pushing down and kind of sticking.
Yeah, it was sticking.
So you got to make sure both of them push down and come up really easily.
Yeah.
Like they're supposed to.
Okay, try the left side. Good. Right side. Excellent. Try your running lights. Try your brake lights. Oh yeah, we got it.